how we did the project, and it's actually going on.
Just to give you some numbers. Here you see the first problem for big data.
Here. It's quite a lot of complaints. But compared to the pieces a day and the events a day, and then the events a year, it's very, very little. And that's always very difficult in data. Because you've got a lot of data, but where you're looking for is quite small. So it's harder to estimate. But we tried it. So what have we done? These were the problems that we want to solve. A lot of costs are involved with the complaint. The reputation of a company. And it reaches out to more than one customer. And that's also reputation, of course. To give you an estimation, a complaint that is fully investigated and all the FTEs that are involved with them, it could go to this amount of money. So around 30 euros per complaint. So the earlier you know that something is going wrong, the better it is for the class, but also for the reputation of the company. So, same as yesterday, what did we do? The first thing the data scientists do is just walk around and see what's happening on the route. What are the influences that have an effect on the quality of the middleman and the middlewoman? So, no data involved yet, we just investigate what are the influences, we think. Well, most are obvious. I think all are obvious. This kind of information that's coming from interviews with team leaders from mailmen. So these are that's sometimes difficult for a scientist because it's the best guess from a team leader. You don't know for sure it's true, but he or she guesses and says. Every time when I've got a person that's working part-time, he always got complaints. Then you ask for the figures, the facts, and they don't have it. It's a feeling. And what happens here? Most team leaders said, people on Saturday, mostly that are students in the Netherlands, that work on Saturday, they're worse than the regular people. It's not the case. It's counterversed. The people working on Saturday work better than our full-timers. So that was a bonus in the investigation. And we have more bonuses. For example, in the Netherlands, what we do is we have e-learning campaigns for mailmen, so they can do an e-learning to see how they have to work. What we found out is that the team leader, they look if someone, and this is a very obvious one, that someone has followed the e-learning. And then he said, well, if you follow the e-learning, then you're good and you can walk your run. They didn't look if they achieved to do the e-learning successfully. It's quite obvious, but from the data that appeared, there was a big difference between the two. And that sometimes happens, sometimes in all the cases we have done, and we have done 16 cases now, in all the cases what appears is that the manager was saying, well, this is obvious, yeah, but why aren't you working in that way if it's obvious? And that's sometimes hard for data scientists. You will find things that are obvious, but they're fact-based, and that's the difference. So what we did, all the influences, we put them into teams. From those teams, we identify which data do we need. So we use data from HR, commerce, logistics, that was internal data, but also external data, like weather data. One of the things was is that team leaders, we found out that because a team leader will discuss with a mailman why he or she thinks there is a complaint in his area. One of the main reasons was it was bad weather. We found from the data that it has to rain for more than 4 hours to have a significant increase in complaints. So that reason, and it was really easy for a mailman to say that because mostly a complaint is 1 week or 2 weeks ago and a team leader doesn't know how was the rain there. So that was also a bonus. We don't tell what to do to a team leader. We just give him the information and the facts. He or she will decide, with this mailman I have to do this, with this mailman I have to do that. That's still managerial responsibility, but we just give him the facts. What you see here is, we build an algorithm based on those data sources. And from that algorithm, what you see here is, because we have done a pilot and now it's running full speed, these areas we didn't do the pilot. In these areas we did do the pilot. You see small dots. For every dot is a round from a mailman. For every dot, we estimate every week what is the chance that there will be a complaint. And that's based on historical data and it's based on actual data. For example, historical data is that mailman in that area last year, last week, how was his performance? Actual data is the planning that is made by the team leader the week before, so the planning for the coming week. So every week the algorithm runs and gives an estimation to the team leader in the top 10 and says, these rounds with your planning and the historical data have a significant probability that there will be a complaint. You can do what you want, but we want you to record what you are doing, because that's the next step. The next step will be that we, because they are building up data, I had a good conversation with my mailman, I did a round together with him, I checked all the mail that he is being given, because what you can see here is there are also mistakes in the process before the mailman gets the mail. So they have to write down the actions. So we're now building up that data, because the next step is that the algorithm will say, in that and that area, I advise you to work together with the mailman based on the data, actual data and historical data. So that's the next step. That's the most difficult word in English, that it's prescriptive. So we now, first we did a root cause analysis, now we're predicting the next step will be predictive, so that we will tell the team leader what is the best next action. That's my story.